sitting at Kavelli Estate in the Stellenbosch area, absolutely stunning views, because yet again on a launch and being spoilt, I love to term it, by Ford South Africa on the launch of the new Ford Everest. And very privileged and honored to be sitting with Ian Foston, who here from Australia for the launch. Ian, your official job title and job designation.
Sure, yeah, I'm the global chief program engineer for the Everest and also the Ranger. So I have the, say, honor of representing Ford and leading the team who have not only designed but also manufactured the products around the world.
And that is the new Everest and Ranger.
Exactly.
The Ranger coming still, but the Everest that we're launching
Correct.
In South Africa today.
The one we're launching today in South Africa, yes.
Fantastic. We've just been through a press briefing and you gave us amazing information, a lot of facts about the vehicle, because this is a stunning vehicle. And what I find amazing is the progress from the previous version and everything you've put into it. But you mentioned you were given quite a very vast but very specific design brief, if I can term it that way.
Yeah, that's correct, yeah. I mean, the car, I mean, on the Everest, we did more research on this product than we've done on any other product in the region in terms of going to customers at different stages of the development and saying, well, what is it that how do you use your car? What is it that you want from an SUV? What is it you don't like about existing SUVs of this kind of size? So we had to make sure that, first of all, the brief was challenging. We had to make sure the car was not only good on road, but also good off road.
Right. That's a really quite a difficult brief in itself, isn't
it?
To make it equally good.
Yeah.
In both aspects.
Absolutely. And you know, customers told us that they wanted to be equally comfortable going driving around town on twisty roads, but also going off onto any terrain in the world and making sure that your car can take you where you want to go. So that was really what people were asking for. And they were saying that, you know, with existing SUVs that are out there, that's not something that necessarily can be delivered. There's always a level of compromise.
Right.
So for us, we were given that challenge. We don't want to compromise. So Ian, you've got to go away with the engineers and find a way of delivering something that delivers both the on and off-road performance. So that was really the big challenge for the engineering team.
Yeah. Well, so far, having driven for a while in the vehicle, I can speak for the on-road performance.
Yeah.
And I actually commented coming through here how comfortable this vehicle is on road.
Good. And that's what we certainly was one of our briefs was, you know, how to make this premium and comfortable but yet practical and durable. So,
right.
You know, going for technology like body on frame construction gives you the durability, reliability and ruggedness of being able to drive off road. But then, well, that generally means you've got quite a heavy car. You've got a live rear axle that needs to be controlled. And having to control all of that and also give you the comfort, we spent a lot of time on then the on-road performance using the Watts Link suspension. We're making sure of architecturally that we could put things like the dampers as far outboard as possible to really make the car comfortable.
Well, as I say, I can only speak for the on-road so far, but that you've got right. And the electric power steering is something I think that's an important one to make it easier to handle on-road. It is a big vehicle, there's no doubt. It's designed to be a big vehicle.
Yep.
It's quite a heavy vehicle.
Yep.
So the electric power steering certainly makes it easier to drive as an on-road everyday drive.
Absolutely. It's one of the key enablers for us to give the driving dynamics that people need in different circumstances. So it's adjustable, as you said. Around town, it's really light and you can park the car easily. On the road, it then weights up and gives you that really nice feeling on the road. And then off-road, it can also be changed at the different terrain management settings to give the optimum performance on the different surfaces. And not only that, it was the key enabler for us to give us that great fuel economy performance on the vehicle by taking away some of the loading from the engine.
That's an interesting technology. And obviously, again, it just shows the developments and the progression of electronics in vehicles recently. And that's quite recent development that allow you to improve the efficiency by different routes, still having all the technology available, having a lot more because you've got so much more technology built into this vehicle, both on-road and off-road technology that you've added to a vehicle of this sort, and allowing it in an efficient manner as well, which I think is so important as well.
Yeah, I mean, for me, the technology as well, we talked about it downstairs in the briefing. I mean, it's got to be usable technology. There's no point having technology that's like a gimmick or a gadget that people will look at and go, oh, that's nice, and then they don't actually use it. We've tried to make everything we've put on the car something that people can practically use. It's either invisible to the customer, so things that they're not even going to see that help keep them safe, or it's technology that we believe is actually something that's any kind of novice who doesn't really know the car can go in, press a few buttons and actually they'll notice a difference straight away in helping them, you know, traverse over the terrain that they want to go over.
Well, you used a catchphrase. You mentioned a novice now. Flatter the novice and assist the expert.
Yep.
And I thought that was really a brilliant catchphrase. I think that's more biased at the off-road side of things.
It's both. It was both on and off road. It was also aimed at things like the driver assist technologies as well. So, how can you flatter the novice by helping them drive down the road, but also, you know, keep a safe distance from the car in front with adaptive cruise control, or making sure that they're told that they're drifting out of the lane? It's something that people who are tech savvy would like to know all the information on the screen, but if you're just a novice, you can actually just use that, and it does it all for you, and it actually provides a real, say, benefit both on and off-road in terms of assisting people in the driving.
Absolutely. So let's talk on-road for a moment, because I think, although it is totally, and I have no doubt about the off-road capabilities, which we're going to prove a bit later on today, but most vehicles like that, of this type that you sell, are going to spend most of their life on-road. And you've built in all... To me, I always, always look at safety.
Yep.
And safety spec on a vehicle. And you've built in so many of these modern safety technologies that are available now and that you are developing even further. And the one I think that was really important to me was, you mentioned now, the adaptive cruise control, but with that added factor of the stopping.
Yeah.
That active stopping, yeah, etc.
The kind of driver collision warning and collision mitigation system.
Yes.
I mean, that is, again, another real user-friendly, user-friendly system that not only will it tell you when you're getting too close to a car in front by looking at the distance away from them and how fast you're closing behind them, but it also then will alert you if you're getting too close. And then finally, if it really believes that you are not going to brake, right, it will actually prime the brake system and brake for you.
So it actively intervenes
in
an emergency situation.
Correct.
Yeah, which, fantastic. As I say, I'm passionate about the safety side, yeah, so I love that. On the luxury side, on the comfort side, it's a seven-seater, four-seven-seater, but you've even got the electric folding mode for the seventh seat, the rearmost two seats, etc. So you've got all these things all in one vehicle.
Yep, exactly. So again, it was a real difficult brief. I think you just said at the start, you know, we got set really aggressive targets for both comfort and performance and MVH and making sure it's quiet in the
right
cabin. And things like the convenience features, I mean, you know, the power liftgate and the power fold third row seats were right up there with some of the features that customers said that, you know, it's not in this segment now, but it's something we think should be. So again, it's something we focused on, was making sure that it's really kind of user-friendly and it makes sure it's convenient for people loading things into the car.
Great. Well, Ian, on that point, thanks so much for your time. As I say, my experience of the vehicle so far, I can only congratulate you on a job exceptionally well done. And I'm sure it's going to be proven during the day today once we hit the off-road section as well. I can see it already. Just feeling it and also looking at the technology you've built into it, I know this is a capable vehicle. So my congratulations. Thanks for your time and thanks for chatting to me.
No, no problem. Say it's a real pleasure to get you guys in the cars, and I want you to drive them, and I want you to then, you know, understand all the passion and the energy that the team's put into this, to making this something we think is going to be a real winner in this segment. Yeah,
absolutely. I fully agree. Thanks very much.
Thanks a lot. Cheers.